A question we get asked a lot with customers using Microsoft 365 is, where do I store my files and where do I share those files from? So I want to show you the two main places I would recommend for any small business to store your files. And we'll start with OneDrive, which is what I have open right now. When you sign up for a subscription, it automatically appears at the top of your screen on the left under Home. And this is where you start working with your files. I'll show you a couple other places where you can work from these location, but for now, what's it look like to just start adding some new files in here? You can just do new and add a document like this. And this document, now that it's in OneDrive, you can access it from anywhere you like in Microsoft 365. If you have a group of files that you want to add to this, then you can drag and drop them to your OneDrive. Another place you'll see OneDrive while working in your Microsoft apps is, we'll open up Microsoft Word, for example. And when you go to save from, you create a document. And when you go to save, the first place you'll see at the very top is OneDrive. With your, that's the default location. You can save it in other locations, as you can see on the bottom here, you know, and the more locations here. But the default location, easy one to remember, is in OneDrive. Another place that you can get to your documents in OneDrive is by opening up a web browser. So we'll take a look at that now. That's where I'm at here. This is OneDrive. in a web browser for your business, and we see the all the documents that we dropped in there a moment ago from here as well. You can edit and work in OneDrive this way, or you can work in OneDrive from your computer, or you can work in OneDrive from your documents. That's where I recommend you putting your things that are for you, your own personal or private documents that aren't ready for working with your coworkers and that sort of thing, use OneDrive. Now, when it comes to files that you're working on with a team, well, for that, I recommend going into Teams and go to Files. If you haven't created a team yet, you know, you won't see any of this. You will need to create a team first. But once you create a team, you'll have posts right here for communicating. You'll have posts here for communicating, and you'll have files to create and save and share with your team. Now, to add files to Teams, it's similar to OneDrive, but here you see a new button right here, and you just choose the type of document and create. That opens up the document in Word where you can start editing it inside of Teams. And if you want to drag and drop a group of files, you can do that too by opening up files like this, and you can just drag and drop them into the team files. And once your files are here, again, you can work on them and you can share them by clicking the share link. And you can type their name to share with here, or choose, my favorite method is to just choose copy, and then now you paste that into either a Teams chat or into an email message and so forth. Files inside of Teams is also the same as SharePoint, which is why we see an open in SharePoint link here. But if you are working on a project with your team, use Teams files. These same, you can open them up from here, save, share, and do that sort of thing. So the two locations for working in Microsoft 365 are OneDrive and Teams. And that's all for today.